Hey, Doc, I feel dizzy. Fix me.
All right, but hold your horses. Before we jump into treatment, we need to figure out exactly what you mean by dizzy. Are you experiencing vertigo, where the whole world is spinning around you? Or are you lightheaded? It feels like you're going to faint or pass out. Or are you having a headache? It feels like your head is in a vice. Or are you unsteady when you're walking? Which one is it?
Oh, okay. I guess I have vertigo then. What causes it?
Well, vertigo is often caused by problems with the inner ear, which has two main structures. The one that looks like a snail is responsible for hearing, and the one that looks like a roller coaster is responsible for balance. These semicircular canals are the main problems in vertigo. Sometimes a little crystal gets stuck in the canals, which lead to symptoms of vertigo. This is called BPPV. Other times, fluid builds up too much in the canals, causing longer-lasting symptoms. This is called Meniere's disease. This disease often comes with ringing of your ear and hearing loss. Vertigo can also be a sign of something more serious too, like a stroke or brain tumor, so always make sure you get seen by a doctor for this.
Cool story, bro. What do I do about it?
Well, we make sure this is due to your ears and not something else. There are physical maneuvers that we can do to try to bring those crystals into the right place, called Epley maneuver. Here's a short video of the dizzy PT, Amy, who explains the Epley maneuver very well on TikTok.
By sitting on the bed, turning your head halfway to the right, and then laying backward. By allowing our head to tip backward over the top of the pillow or off the edge of the bed, we allow those crystals to fall backward in the canal. After 1 to 2 minutes, we can turn our head to the left all the way, which, if you look carefully, makes those crystals tumble further back in the canal. As a reminder, the objective of this maneuver is to get the crystals to go backward in the canal and to land back into that main sac. The next step is to roll onto your left side and turn your nose down into the bed. A different angle shows that the crystals don't really have any more places to go because you force them all the way back. And the last step is to sit up with your head still twisted to the left.
Or medications to help decrease your vertigo. If it's something serious, we will send you to get some imaging of your brain and go see a neurologist.
Oh, actually, I think I probably have lightheadedness. What causes that?
Ah, lightheadedness is often caused by low blood pressure. Usually it's because you're dehydrated, but when you get older or if you have problems with your autonomic nervous system, you can have something called orthostatic hypotension, which is just a fancy word for having low blood pressure when you stand up too quickly. Your body doesn't compensate fast enough to bring blood to your brain, so you faint and you pass out.
Cool. What do I do about it?
Well, you can make sure you are well hydrated, take your time going from lying to sitting, and sitting to standing. Using compression stockings can be helpful as well.
Oh, actually, I probably have a headache. What causes that?
Oh boy. Headache can be caused by many things. Most commonly, tension-type headache, which is caused by a combination of stress and muscle tension in the neck and head. Migraines are just as common, often one-sided, pulsating, and comes with nausea and can be very debilitating. Headache, like vertigo, can be an indication of something much more sinister, especially if you are over 50 years old, have blurry vision, or you have a very sudden, extremely painful headache, any weakness on one side of your body.
Oh, that sounds more like what I have. What do I do about it?
Oh, thank God. For a normal tension-type headache, Tylenol and ibuprofen can work well. Massaging your neck, muscles can relieve some tension too. For migraines, pain medicine also works. Oftentimes, patients need to stay in a very quiet and dark room for hours to try to sleep it off. If the attacks get frequent enough, you should talk to your doctor about preventative medication to prevent the attacks. Now, if you have any of the symptoms I mentioned before, you might want to go straight to the emergency.
Awesome. Thanks, Doc. Well, actually...
No more! I gotta go. See you next time.